What would they do if you moved on? So if you decided to move on, what would that make them do? That's what we want to know today. How do they feel? How would they feel about you moving on? Welcome back to Hope Tarot Daily. My name is Angie. I'm a tarot card reader from England. This tarot reading is between you, the universe, and your intuition. If you decide to claim the reading, put a like on the video. If you want to support the channel, put a like on the video. It really does make a difference with such a small channel. It's saying YouTube, there's something other people may want to watch. But we want to know. It's timeless. It's relevant when you come into contact with it. We want to know. We want to know all of the things. How would they react? What would they do if you actually totally disconnected and decided to just get on with life? I'm going to do a Celtic cross for them. I want to see what's all around them at the moment. And the opportunity to come is you disconnecting, and then the rest of the cards after that will be their reaction to that. So I'm going to split the deck into four elements, four seasons. Most importantly, four angels offering us a circle of protection. So we can give and receive all of these messages with an open heart and an open mind. The first card is all about them. Love. It's all about them, but it could also be about the question is, this connection. What would happen with this connection if you actually moved on? If you decide to claim the ring, put a little like on the video. But if you just want to support the channel, put a like on the video. So the first card's all about the thing. An Ace of Wands. Do you know, there's a real nice connection between you both, and I can see, I can feel why you haven't moved on yet, why you haven't given up on this yet, because I've got a feeling when it's just the two of you, the chemistry's there, the passion's there, the potential's there, the connection's there, the meeting of two people, it feels right and it feels good. And this is a reading based on them. So I'm reading that from their energy, not yours. Because your energy is getting to the point of I've had enough of this. I might move on. So around them at the moment, the Magician, the Lovers. Behind them is the Three of Wands, which is probably when you both first came into contact, right? So the opportunity ahead, which I'm picking as the moment that you decide to move on, King of Pentacles. If you actually decide to move on and really, really mean it and really are like, get to the point of disconnecting from this, they could possibly well offer you security. The Star, King of Cups, needs being met. And a Seven of Swords is a possible outcome. I'm going to do clarifying because I want to know all of the things. We both want to know all of the things, don't we? So the power for this is all in their hands, and it always has been all in their hands. You get a bit sick of waiting. The King of Pentacles is making you wait quite a long time, maybe dealing with an earth sign, or maybe a Gemini. Random, I know, but that's what's coming in. The Lovers card, there's a nice connection between you both. The Two of Cups, there's a nice connection between you both. The Magician, they haven't quite yet recognized what is in front of them. They haven't appreciated it yet. The Three of Wands in the past is the moment that you both came together, but it's almost like you both came together, but maybe both or one of you kept options open a bit. The Star is the secret question. Can we cleanse what's happened and can we get it back together again? The King of Pentacles is them offering you security. The timing on this is the King of Cups, so it's all up to them. The Kings to me are the people you're connected to, whether you're male or female, and the Queens are the people that come to my table asking. It doesn't matter what your gender is, that's just the way I read. The Four of Pentacles, possible attainment, is them offering you something and holding on to you. But the Seven of Swords is interesting. It's the Seven of Swords to me is a pension pot for the future. It could be sneaky behaviour, but it's mainly trusting your instincts. You've got to do what is right for you. The power of this is in their hands. They can stop you walking away or they can watch you go, you know. So I'm going to clarify from the Magician all the way round. See what other information we can find. I'm going to split the deck into four elements, four seasons, most importantly four angels. I do personal readings, they're available from my website. And if you ever wonder what decks I'm using, I've got them listed on my website. I don't do reversals with my Celtic Cross, but she did come out reversed. The Queen of Swords, when she's reversed, she's annoyed. It's like, you know that you know the power of this is in their hands and you've been waiting, and I think you are just getting to the point of comfortable to wait anymore. How much longer are they going to take? It's like they're going on snail mail and you want everything now. And you are getting to the point of, yeah, you feel like they're keeping you in limbo and it's not fair. It's like you're waiting for them to wake up. It's like you want to jolt them so that they make jump. You know, they make the leap, that they make the choice. There's a sacrifice here that they need to make to move forward. But there's equally a sacrifice here that you need to make to move forward. Now, the sacrifice is, if you move on, the sacrifice could potentially be they watch you go, or you start moving on, and then the sacrifice you have to make is not moving on because they want you back. You know, it's a risk. That is a risk, but the Queen of Swords is always willing to take that risk. She like puts it into the universe. I've had enough of this, so I'm off. You want me nowhere to find me, but otherwise I'm off. Blunt, bossy, independent. I think you've communicated quite clearly with them, but you do recognise that they have to be aware of what is on offer to them first. And even if they're aware of it, I don't think they realise that this is all up to them, really. I'm not sure if they realise they're about to lose you, or potentially. We've got the Ace of Wands. There's a very nice chemistry between you both. It's been coming up a lot today, all this desire and passion and just lovely naughtiness. But that's not, sometimes we need more than that, don't we? Again, the power is in our hands. But by having you having a Queen of Swords moment, you're taking the power and you're saying, right, okay, well, you're not just going to leave me in limbo for another 4 years while I wait to see what you're going to do. Because, you know, it feels like you want to live life. And the Nine of Wands. Yeah, it's been going on for a while. The Nine of Wands is all about being ready, your inner strength, your willingness to just go, had enough. There is a nice connection here, but is it worth it? If they're not going to stop you from going, why stay? You know, they've got to fight for it, haven't they? Because I've got a feeling you've been fighting for this for a while. They've got to fight for it as well. They can't just... Yeah, they're a bit slow. Knave of Cups, teenage butterfly feelings, and the Five of Cups. There's something that holds them back. So when you first both came into contact with each other, there's all those attractive flirtatiousness, happiness, desire, passion, butterfly feelings, making each other feel giddy. But instead of very quickly committing to one another, it was like, well, let's see how long it takes for either one of us to commit. And it feels like there was a window of opportunity missed of like cementing this into a fully committed relationship. And I've got a feeling it was missed by them, because pages or knaves are quite often all about the ideas, but then they don't know how to get the ideas off paper or out of their heads into a plan and actually making it happen. They missed a window of opportunity of however it was that you both met, if it was on a dating app or whatever, it's almost like they kept one foot in and one foot out. So you disconnect him, we've got the star. So the moment you disconnect, they're going to be even more drawn towards you. Of course they are. The Ten of Wands, they're going to work very hard. And they're going to make you an offer. They're going to make you an offer. But first of all, they need to realise that you have disconnected. And they have to get that feeling that you have disconnected. And it's almost like the moment that happens, they're drawn back towards you. On the star for the secret question, we have the Three of Wands. Have they really given up the past? Have you really given up the past? And the Strength card, can you both overcome it? Yep, yeah, you can. The King of Cups has the Six of Coins. They have to be the one to make you the offer. They need to make you an offer that's better than what you might have with somebody else. And then we have the Five of Wands, a little bit of friction calling you back in again, competitions and challenges. The moment that they feel that competition's there, oh, and got their unconditional love, please come back, I'm going to give you security. but you have to really mean it when you've disconnected. There's a difference between pretended you disconnected in the hope that they're going to offer you something and actually losing interest and going, oh, I've had enough, I deserve better than this. There's a big difference. Three of Cups, celebrations. Eight of Wands, fast messages between each other. King of Cups, again, there's a lot of love here. And the Devil, frustration. Yeah, what are they going to do? The moment you move on, they're going to be like, excuse me, where are you going? I'm suddenly aware of how I feel. Don't want you to go anywhere. Got a feeling that one of you or both of you have been keeping your options open. I've got a feeling it's probably them. I'm just clearing my throat. I'm not being, like, sassy. Yeah. It feels like there could potentially be a very nice relationship here. But then again, I'm like, have they left it too late? Why did the Queen of Swords moment have to come before this? And do you really want it? Do you really want it? That's another question that's here. Do you really want this? Because there's lots of fire and passion and desire and everything. And there's the potential for building a life. But I'm not sure if the Queen of Swords is buying it. I'm not sure if you're buying it. You may just be going, oh God, there's so many of these readings that say that they're going to come back. I'm not saying they're coming back. I'm saying they're going to offer you something. How long that's going to take? Just got to wait for them feelings to catch up. They're going to be guided back to you with the star. We've got two stars on the table. And it's almost, it feels like to me, there is a genuine moment of where you've kind of just let go of this and thought, yeah, I like them as a person. Yeah, I want them to do well in life. I'm not sure they're for me. I've told them how I feel. They haven't said it back. And you're coming from that place of feeling healed and feeling okay with walking away and never hearing from them again. And it may take them a bit to realise that you've actually stopped messaging them or stopped replying to them or stopped being available to them. And it has to be them that offers it. It can't be you that says, right, you either take me now or I'm going. It can't be you that has the ultimatum. It feels like a sense of you just losing interest. And then I think, well, if you get to the point of where you have lost interest and you're genuinely at the point of they've kind of lost you, what do you want? Because the Devil's there. That's what's making me think, What do you want? Because they're going to be quite powerless in that situation, you know. They are going to be, it's going to be you, you're the one. At the moment, the power is all in their hands. And maybe that's what it's going to take. Maybe that's what the balance needs to be. At the moment, the power is all in their hands. And you are waiting for them to catch up. And you are waiting for them to become aware of what they're actually about to lose. But that moment when they realise that, the power then is in your hands. I've got a feeling you might play with them. For some reason, I've got a cat with a mouse. And, you know, they don't kill them straight away. They play with them. They tease them, they sit around, they get distracted, they go back, and it feels like it could become a bit of a game on your part. And I don't know what you want. I don't know what you want from this. And that surprised me, really. Maybe you want them to want you so that you could tell them to get stuffed. I don't know. It does feel like, with the Queen of Swords coming out, the deck reversed, even though it's the right way up in my Celtic cross, it does feel like maybe they've really lost their chance with you, you know. And they could come on hands and knees, and you may invite that and go along with that. But there's part of me that thinks then, a little bit of a game here, but I don't know what that is. I don't know whether it's then you seeing your opportunity of you hurting them, because I've got a feeling they have hurt you emotionally, of because they have kept themselves open. I've got a feeling that if you met on a dating app, that you're aware that they stayed on that dating app, even though you two were very close and connected, and there is a real nice connection between you both. And those connections don't always happen. And maybe if they did stay on that dating app, and if you don't know whether they stayed on a dating app, I'm not telling you something you don't know. If you don't know that, then that's not what happened. But if you know that they stayed on a dating app, it may have been that period of time that then made them realise that there's no one else that matches up to you, that they don't have this connection with anybody else. But it does feel like they've kept their options open a little bit too long, and you're just a bit sick of it. And it's coming, it feels like your energy's just meh. I'm off. I'm done. If they want to come and play, I'm going to play. I've got Harlequin from the Joker in my head. That kind of swinging a bat, you know? That's what's in my head for you. And that's interesting. Be careful though, be careful you don't end up getting hurt. Because, you know, there's a nice connection here. And I do think sometimes it just takes someone a little bit of time to catch up. But I do think you got sick of it. But they're going to come, you know, you're going to think, no, I'm not going to hear from them again. You're going to hear from them when you least expect it. The moment when you very least expect it, you're going to disconnect, you're going to move on, you're going to be doing your thing, and then out of the blue, completely out of the blue, they're going to contact you and offer you something. And it's going to be so out of the blue that it's going to take you back. And depending on what mindset you're in at that point, it's either going to make you really happy or make you think, game on, let's do this then. And this is a very specific reading for the right person. If you resonate with this, put a like on the video. Let me know, you know, or support the channel by putting a like on it. But yeah, that's the message I've got. They need to be careful, I think. I do think they need to be careful. Because the longer they leave it, I think the more it's going to be a bit of a cat and mouse for you. Oh, right, you are interested then. Well, you hurt me, so payback. Maybe. That's interesting. I wasn't expecting that at all. So anyway, I'm gonna back out of this reading because you're a little bit intimidating, but I can understand it. I can understand it. If you're serious about someone and they've kept their options open, and it's not until you really disconnect and they really realize that you've gone that they come back, that's rude, isn't it? So I'm gonna end the reading here. I'm gonna wrap you in a massive bubble of protection so that your angels can take you on your way. Gonna wrap myself in a bubble of protection because, if you'd like me to pull a card for you when I have my coffee in the morning, I'm more than happy to pull a card for you. Getting in the comments and talking to you guys is my favorite part of the day. I do it about 3 or 4 times a day. I like it. It makes all of this worthwhile. If you see purple hearts way down there, you're now part of a secret purple heart gang, other people that make it to the very end of a reading. So welcome to the crew. There's not very many of you, but it is growing, and I do appreciate all of you. And I will see you soon.